I am here at DCA today because it is the first weekend of Food and Wine 2024. This is my favorite festival every single year. I'm so excited to be here. I'm gonna try and not do a part two. So I do have a friend that is on her way to come and eat with me so we can try and get, you know, more things done. But I'm really excited. Let's go get the Sip and Savor Pass and get started. Let's go. So today is Saturday the 2nd and the festival officially started yesterday, but they did 2 days of soft opening and the festival goes through April 25th, I think. Once I get the Sip and Savor Pass, I will confirm the dates for sure. Got the Sip and Savor Pass and I asked for the Magic Key one. It was $56 of 8 tastings, has the barcode and everything like we had at Lunar New Year, but let's go ahead and open the book and get started.
All right, I used 7 so far. So we got the Impossible Chicken, Parmesan Bites, Barbecue Pork Mac and Cheese, which is what we're starting with, Carbonara Mac and Cheese, Empanada de Chile Relleno, the Cheeseburger Bao, the Cheese Pizza Wings, and the Brisket Slider. There was one I wanted to try, but you have to go to that booth. I couldn't order ahead. And then the last date for this is April 22nd. I said 25th, so I was close. It's just easier to order all at once and then just keep going around and picking up instead of getting in two lines every single time.
Spider-Man is going on behind me, so I apologize if it's a little loud, but I'm starting with the barbecue pulled pork mac and cheese, which honestly, this is one of my favorite dishes like of all time. I don't even think I've had this one at Disneyland, just like in general. Love pulled pork, love mac and cheese, love barbecue sauce. That's like the go-to for me, so hoping this is gonna be a winner. Guess who forgot her tripod again though? So hopefully as soon as my friend gets here, the video quality gets better, but cheers. Yep, that's it. I personally would put like a ton more barbecue sauce on it because I love barbecue sauce, but I like this. That's a good one.
Look who decided to show up and save me from being alone today.
So there's 2 Sip and Savor passes. We got the Magic Key one. I didn't ask what the other one was, but I know without the discount it's 61. With the discount it was 56. But we're gonna go ahead and go to Hollywoodland and start at booth number 1 and 2 and then work our way down, up, up, down,
down and up, all the way around.
Let's go.
Okay, we got the Impossible Chicken Parmesan. They look like little chicken nuggets. We went to get the pork belly and they were out. So we'll have to come back for that one.
Okay. Looks like chicken.
Okay, I'm gonna get this by then.
Cheers. Chicken nugget with red sauce and cheese. It's good. Doesn't taste fake at all. But it's literally just a chicken nugget.
It's really crispy though. Like the outside is really crispy.
Wearing my Pizza Planet jacket today. It's the only food related clothing I have. So Food and Wine. It's not wow. Just chicken nuggets.
Okay, I didn't realize Miranda was gonna want the mac and cheese too, so we went back and got her own. And the first thing she said was, it looks like it needs more barbecue sauce, which was the exact thing that I said.
It's good.
Just need sauce. Carbonara mac and cheese, fan favorite every year. I'm obsessed with this one. Little mac and cheese, cheers.
Cheese paste. Now next, this chef specializes in a smooth, rolling simmer. Chef Al Fredo.
Correct, usually that is on a stage, is it not? They just put it here in the middle this year? I wonder how that's working. Uh-huh. Miranda said, wait, she's not ready. Hold up. And go. That's why it's a fan favorite. This is probably, what, the 4th year that they've had it? Just looking at it. It looks so good. So which mac and cheese is better? That one?
That one? That one's got the sauce. For sure.
Okay, we are 3 meals in. We have a lot more to go, but I'm already getting full. So we're gonna go on Mermaid, take a little nappy nap, and then keep going. I should have not ordered so much food at one time. Because now we like have, yeah, we've had pasta so far. Next up is chicken wings, brisket slider, and lemonade. So we got three more at one booth to tackle. I should have not ordered so much so fast. This is what everyone's been craving about. These are the cheeseburger wings?
Cheese pizza.
Sorry. The cheeseburger is the bao bun. We didn't get that one yet. Okay. I think I'm on cinematic mode right now. Whoops.
Okay, I'm going to try the drink first because I'm thirsty. But you go ahead, girl.
I'm
going to
try this first.
They did move some of the booths around this year, so they're not in the same spot as they usually are. Oh my god. Lemonade, for sure. Not that it was a bad flavor, but... Oh. So too big of a bite, we gotta wait.
It's a lot of meat.
That looks like a lot of meat. I'm scared to bite into that too.
What is this?
Kiwi apple lemonade. Like, the flavor is good, but it punches you at the end.
You could definitely taste the apple. I can't really taste the kiwi.
But that lemonade sourness, like, really hits you at the end.
It doesn't taste like lemonade, it tastes like limeade.
Yeah. I feel like it tastes like a Jamba Juice, like...
smoothie that's melted?
Like a shot. Like, you know how they have their green, like their green juice type of shot? I feel like that's like apple, celery, lime type of...
Like, it's not like sour lime. It's sour lime. It's not like a... It's a... Ooh.
I'm disappointed. I was really excited to like chug that. Should we try that, or should I try this first one?
No. I don't think I'll be eating that one. It was too much for me.
I think the flavor is fine. I think it tastes exactly like it did last year. I think they just gave us way too much meat, where I get like grossed out because it's almost too much. So I think we'll take some off, and then I might eat it. On to the next one.
Oh, I'm scared for this. Like, I'm excited, but scared. I want to
literally
just...
What, four? Give me four wings, man.
I don't catch.
I'm going to try one with ranch. And one without.
I'm so scared for this.
It's very dry. I get it, it's a dry rub, but
it tastes like...
Sorry, it's shaking so much. Just the table.
It tastes like if someone put the Parmesan bites in the oven too long.
Yeah, it's really dry. The chicken itself is fine. It's the crust of the chicken.
Yeah.
It's literally like they dry rub patted it on there, and then they were like, okay, that's it. Almost like they put the rub on after they cooked the chicken wing. Like, it didn't, like,
you could taste the pizza at first, like what they tried to do with it, but then the chicken just overpowers it.
Yeah. You don't like ranch at all?
Is it better with ranch?
I'm really happy with what this turned out to be. And I was really excited for that.
The carbonara was fire.
So carbonara, I think, has been our only win so far.
The mac and cheese was...
Yeah, it was whatever. Same with the chicken parm bites. It was just chicken nuggets.
Okay, what would you rate in order?
I'm sad because people said that this was supposed to be better than the cheeseburger bao bun. We haven't even picked that up yet. And I'm a little disappointed with this. I like ranch, so I'm just gonna keep soaking it in ranch. No doubt about it. Yeah, we forgot our napkins too.
I've never had my cat.
All right, welcome back. When it's time for, we have the chuleta anna and the bao bun left. Yeah, it's a weird, like, right at the end.
I taste the plant now.
Yeah, like celery.
Yeah, I taste that now.
Tastes like a green juice.
I taste it now. I didn't taste it at first. I only tasted the apple and the limeade. Now I taste the celery-ish.
Yeah, it tastes like Jamba Juice.
I feel like that's something you have to crave.
I don't think I'd ever take that. But.
It's raining now. It's legitimately, like, we didn't come prepared because the sun came out.
They did say it wasn't going to rain 2 to 5 to 6.
You didn't tell me that.
I sent you a screenshot.
Okay, maybe this video is going to get cut short. We'll see.
The last time I went on Soarin', I was actually at Epcot, and it was on New Year's Day right after it turned to midnight, and it was soaring over California, and I was at Epcot, so... First day of Food and Wine. I didn't realize my flash was on.
I've never been at Soarin' over California.
Really?
It's my first time.
Okay, let's go.
Okay, hair wet. Miranda ended up throwing away the mango beer slush.
It was just too much, like, mango. Well, mango cart is like a beer, but I don't know. It had a lot of tahini, and it was just, I don't know.
I like straight beer.
I like straight beer.
That was not straight beer, so that's why I didn't try it. Now we're waiting in the drizzle for Soarin'
over California.
I got the worst seat, row 3, on the right side.
My name is Patrick, and I'll be your chief.
I'm so sorry. It's going to be a bad first time.
I know, it's my first time.
We'll begin boarding in a few minutes, but first I'd like to acquaint you with some important safety information.
We made our way inside. We're gonna go over Food and Wine merch that's available inside. So these are the ears. They are by Loungefly.
What am I gonna say? What's the word that I use all the time?
They're disgusting.
Yes.
Are you saying I'm a fan?
She does watch my YouTube videos.
These are my Loungefly. These are the Loungefly Food and Wine Festival ears. Yeah, it's a no for me. These are
literally disgusting.
I'm
not a big fan.
The like, avocado, Mickey's what is cute. Avocado? Yeah, because it's called avocado time, and that's cheese.
Didn't we learn what the ratatouille is?
Yeah.
Didn't we learn?
Mickey's cute, though. I don't like spirit jerseys.
But I would just never wear it again.
Yeah, it's like a one and done type thing for me. Used to be a fan of spirit jerseys, not anymore. Up next is Pepper's Caliente. Bringing the heat. That's what you need a shirt that says that for work. Bringing the heat.
We got that fire. We got that fire.
Is there anything on the back?
No.
All right, and on to the Magic Key shirt. There's a matching backpack to this, but I don't know if it's here right now. I saw it outside. Here's the Magic Key Holder shirt. It has the names of the booths.
This is a salt shaker.
These are coasters. So it has the names of the booths. Okay, we got wine. Look at this avocado.
It's a mug?
Mug. $24.99. And yeah, we got the wine glasses. So they pretty much just threw like the names of the booths and just threw it on everything. Again, there's a matching Loungefly backpack. We just gotta find it, but I think it's outside. So usually if I buy anything, it's usually a pin. So I feel like that's a lot easier to just remember. This one, it doesn't have the year on it, but this one does. So if I would get one, it would be Mickey.
We are making our way back to Pepper's Caliente to pick up our chile relleno. I don't know if we're going to get to the cheeseburger bao bun today. I already, like, ordered it, so it's on my receipt, and I don't want to waste it, but I'm already, like, struggling to walk to get to this other booth. One, I'm tired. Two, I'm cold and wet. Three, I'm full. But we're doing it for the video. Let's at least go get the empanada to start.
All right. We found the backpack, so it wasn't available up at the front in the store, but here's the Loungefly. Don't know what the price is. $58. What? Is there a print inside? What's the print? Oh, so it's the same as the ears. Okay. Well, they do have it here. Same with the shirt, and I believe they have the pins over here too. They do have all the merch available out here. Usually this merch booth is over there, but they moved it, which I think helps with the flow of traffic a little bit. So it's all out here too. All right, this is the chile relleno empanada. We're gonna cut it open so we can see what the inside's looking like. This one doesn't look as fat. All right, taste test time. I love this one. It's so good.
Let's see the inside. Ten out of ten?
Yeah.
I let Miranda try like one little bite of the empanada and it was too spicy for her. Literally gave her like the end crust piece, but I thought it was good. 10 out of 10, but we need a soda now. Are burning a little bit from that Coke. I'm a Dr. Pepper girly, so
it's crispy.
It's crisp. We are gonna power through cheeseburger bao bun time. I think this is the last. We didn't get dessert though.
Should I get the raspberry cake?
You can do the raspberry, or we that I've tried before, just okay. Not this year.
Olive oil thing.
Okay, raspberry, olive oil, or the churro.
I'm going for the churro.
Okay, we're gonna do the churro.
Okay, I don't really like tomatoes, so I'm definitely gonna take that off when I go to bite it. Looks like pickles, onions, tomato, Thousand Island, sesame seeds. We're gonna cut it open so you can see what the inside looks like. So, we're gonna go ahead and try it. Okay, I tried to leave the pickle and onion on. Miranda's not gonna try it because she doesn't like Thousand Island sauce, but here we go. I think I'm too full to like this right now. But the meat is cooked well. I don't mind the Thousand Island. Tastes like In-N-Out, just different bread. It's not bad. I'm just really full right now.
Making our way to Hollywood Land to pick up the cannoli churro. You can use your Sip and Saver pass on this one. I believe there's three or four new churros for the festival, but I think you can only use your Sip and Saver pass on two of them. It's in the little booklet. So here's the tasting passport. So it goes over, obviously, like how to use your Sip and Saver pass, and then it goes over everything that's at the booth. So starting with one, all the way through. They have the different symbols that show you if it's like vegan or vegetarian, and then the little like spoon and fork that shows you that you can use it with your Sip and Saver pass. So at the end, they have all of these that are participating locations that are not like actual festival booths. So like Boardwalk Pizza and Pasta, most of the things over there you can't use it on. There's a festival cart item that you can use it on. Here are the churros. So they have four new ones. So we're gonna try the cannoli one. They have an unforgettable Bing Bong churro. I feel like knowing Bing Bong, that's gonna be straight candy. Spiced shortbread churro, and then the butterscotch banana churro. So only the one on Buena Vista Street in Hollywood Land can you use the Sip and Saver pass. And then in the back, they have a little map so you know where everything is. Had to turn on the flash for this one so you could see it in all of its glory. Oh. Hey, do you want to take the first bite?
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay, I'm going to try this one.
I don't think I've had an actual cannoli before, so I don't know if I'm like the right person to judge this.
All right, cheers. Yeah, it's pretty good. Kind of like a whipped cream on top, but thicker. I don't think it's actual like what goes in a cannoli. That looks...
I like that they're just chocolate chips because it doesn't like overpower.
I liked it.
It's good.
All right, friends, we are calling it a night here at California Adventure. I think we did everything that we could possibly do in one day for Food and Wine. I think the only thing we didn't get was the pork belly because they were sold out.
Yeah.
If we got it, we definitely wouldn't have finished because the last couple things we didn't even fully eat. There was a couple little festival options that they have. There was like carnita fries, pastrami fries at like other locations that were like not booths, so we only tried food booths today. So maybe we will have to do a part two. I don't know, we'll see. Thank you guys so much for following along. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. You can follow me on Instagram and TikTok at Pixie at the Parks, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye, friends.